some kind of rules to find the first of a number. So there are three rules. The rule number one is, if a is epsilon, then first of a is a itself, sorry, is epsilon, then first of a is also epsilon. Then rule number two is, if a is a variable, then rule number two should be like this. If a is a terminal, then first of a is a itself. And rule number three is something like this. If a is a variable, and we have a productions like this, a can derive x1, x2, x3, where x1 is defined as a/b/epsilon, x2 is defined as c/d/epsilon, and x3 is defined as e/f/epsilon. Now, if I want to find the first of a, then it can be written as first of x1, x2, x3. Okay, where first of x1 is a, b, epsilon union, because this epsilon can be removed, right? So because we have epsilon union the first of x2 and x3. If let us suppose the first of x2 is c, d, epsilon, then this epsilon can be removed if we make it a union with first of x3. So if the first of x3 is e, f, epsilon, therefore if you take the union of all these, therefore the first of a can be written like this: a, b, c, d, e, f, epsilon, right? Now, but if they don't contain this epsilon, if a does not contain this epsilon, then this will not be there, and because this will not be there, so we don't need to check in the other steps, right? This is only we are going to follow this step only if it is going to contain epsilon here. Okay, let us do one thing. Let me take one more simple example here. So I'll take two more examples, don't worry. The first example is, if the grammar is like this, S can derive AB, where A can derive CD, where C can derive a/epsilon, where D can derive B. Now, if I want to find the first of S, let us discuss about S. If I want to find the first of S, now the first of S is first of a, b. And what is the first of A? The first of A is the first of A is CD. So that means the first of A is driving through CD. So first of A can be found out by first of C, D. And this first of C, if I discuss about the first of C, it can be written as small a, comma, epsilon. Now, because there is an epsilon here in the case of first of C, therefore we have to find the first of D, and the first of D is small b. Therefore, the first of C can be written as a, b. Hence, because the first of C is a, b, therefore, the first of S is driving through A. So first of S is a, b. Okay, don't worry if you don't understand this, there's no issues with it, because that without even knowing all this information, you can find the first of a number. Okay, first of a variable. Okay, don't worry. This is just for explanation purposes, that it is kind of an algorithm that how you find the first of a particular number. And if you don't even know this, there's no issues whatsoever. Okay, let me give you one more example. Assuming that this is a grammar, E can derive T E dash, where E dash can derive epsilon/+T E dash, where T can derive F T dash, where T dash can derive epsilon/*F T dash, where F can derive ID/(E). Assuming this is the grammar we have. Now let us try to find the first of all these symbols, the first of all these left hand side here. We want to find the first of these numbers. Okay, now let us take them one by one. The first one is E. So we want to find the first of these numbers, the first of these variables, first of E, first of E dash, then we want to find first of T, then we'll be finding first of T dash, then we'll be finding first of F. That means I've written all of them here. Okay, now let us do with the method which I told you, that is, we want to find the first of e. That is the first variable here. This one, I want to find the first of e. Now this first of e can written as first of t comma e dash. Now what is the first of t? First of t is first of t is first of f t dash. You can check it. First of t is first of f t dash. And further, if you want to find first of f t dash, then you have to find first of f. So it is first of f. And you can see in f we have id. First of f, the f is id and slash this opening bracket id. There is no right. So we have id here as opening bracket. This is not epsilon, this is opening bracket. The first of this is id and opening bracket. Okay, so because this is the first of this is id and opening bracket, hence the first of this is not containing epsilon. The first, in case of first of e, this is not containing epsilon, this is not containing epsilon, this is not containing epsilon, therefore we don't need to find the first of e dash. So hence if I find the first of e, then first of e is id comma n comma opening bracket, id comma opening bracket. Okay, now if you want to find the first of e, see, you don't even need to follow all these steps. Okay, let me explain it to you again. If you want to find the first of e dash, I want to find first of e dash, right? First of e dash. Now if you want to find the first of e dash, in that case, you know, this production is like this. E dash can derive epsilon slash plus t e dash, right? So here, because of this production, there's no issues, because here in this case I can clearly see we have plus as a first symbol, right? But if this is containing epsilon here, there's no issues, then e dash should have epsilon in the first, right? So here we have plus and epsilon as the first of e dash. Next, if we have t, right? So first of t, we want to find the first of t, right? So then, you know, what is the production of first of t? That's t can drive f t dash. Now we have to find what is the first of f. Now first of f is id and opening bracket, therefore the first of t is also id and opening bracket. So it is id and opening bracket. Now we have to find the first of t dash. So in case of t dash, you can see it, the production is like this. T dash can derive opening epsilon slash star f t dash. Now here, because we have a variable here, here we have star, so which is a terminal, and here we have epsilon, therefore the first is star and epsilon. So it is star and epsilon, because star is a terminal. Okay, now if we discuss about f, we know the first of f is id and opening bracket. Okay, don't worry if you don't understand this, I'm going to take more example, then let me explain it to you again. When I'm saying first of a particular variable, particular variables, if you try to generate all any string from that, starting from that particular variable, then what is the first symbol you can have? For example, if we have t here, now t can derive f t dash. Now if you replace f with any particular variable, you know, you can replace f by two things. Either you can replace by f by id, or you can replace by opening bracket e closing bracket. So it can be written as f id t dash, where id is a terminal, therefore the first of t is id. Again, you can also have t can derive f t dash, and you can replace this f by opening bracket e closing bracket t dash, where opening bracket is a terminal. So that is why the first of t is opening bracket, right? So this is the case. Whenever I'm finding first, it is not a very complicated process, it is a very simple process. You only have to see, if you try to generate any string from this, then what is the first symbol you can have. Okay, or can say what is the first terminal you can have. Let me take more examples of the first.